It's Sunday, it's the beginning of June, and I'm sat in my office studio thing. As you can see, I've got my guitars and various photography equipment and my big PC for editing and that's my little laptop down there for music. And yeah, it's a big mess at the moment and needs a clean up. But I'm just doing a very, very quick demonstration vlog of the Doom box, the noise generating box that I made last summer during the first lockdown, which I've since making it, I've completely neglected it. So, this is finally it being tested now. So, hope you enjoy it. And yeah, let me know. I'm thinking that I might make a sample pack out of it or something like that, but yeah, let me know what you think. Okay, so this is the box. This is the basic setup. So you can see I've got just like a thick spring there. I've got some guitar strings coming out, some little springs, just some floor pads, and a little like rubber pad or something there, and just like a little. So that, as you can hear, is just going straight out the side. There's a contact mic underneath it, and I've got little. I wanted to make these somehow like react to when you press them, like generate something, but I need some more circuitry in it, so it probably will be upgraded and things at the moment. So, but yeah, so that's literally just running into a digital reverb pedal. And you can see the settings I've got it on. So set to plate, big decay time, tone all the way up, level quite high. And then that's just going straight into an old Washburn 15 watt bass amp. And that's literally it. That's all you're hearing at the moment. So yeah, this is the sound of it. Apologies for any sounds you hear in the background. The cat's whining and the window's open because it's bloody hot in here. So here's just a few sounds. So this is the basic, just the box. Thank you. So that's it. It's very, very simple inside. Like I say, it is literally just a contact mic. I'll see if I can just open it up for you. So if I just show you that. As you can see, it's literally nothing special inside. It is mainly empty space. It's the control. The mic's attached. There's just shit coming through the top. But there's plenty of space if I wanted to add anything else to it. This is just a very, very basic thing for now. But yeah, that's it. That's the what I call the Doom Box. Originally, I made it so it could be used as part of like the atmospheric backgrounds of the short films I make. So the plan is really to hook it up to the laptop and just record raw sounds and then add the effects in basically as I'm going along, you know, just put like really good delay on it, really good reverb, make it sound as spooky and horrible as possible. Sorry this sounded as rattly as it did, but there's not really much room, so it's kind of like hanging off the edge, and you can see there are little supports underneath for it to not rattle, but it's sat basically right on this shelf. It's, yeah, not the best surface. So the plan is eventually to just use a multi-effects pedal, which I do have kicking about somewhere, but it's this piece of crap, it's old, and run that. And I'll show you this as well. And my circuit bent M0 synth. So basically this will most likely have a split output, so I can run it into here as well, or do like a return send signal and then run that out to a little mixer, and then yeah, that'll be that. So maybe, so I should hopefully be able to do some like little improvised sets or something like that. But that's it in its raw form. Hope people enjoyed that. Hope people are interested in building. Like I say, this took me, what, altogether about a day to do, just drilling holes. But, you know, it took me longer because I bought things and then added to it and stuff. But, in terms of actual time, you know, I think this box, the actual box itself, cost me like £6 on Amazon. And, you know, guitar strings, just basic acoustic guitar strings, nothing special. Some springs, I've just got a set of springs, and a door spring I got from Wilco's, along with the other bits and pieces. The paint was just, actually, it was just normal printer's ink. It was the same thing that I did the design with. I just did like a, what do you call it, a lino print of that skull and stuff, and just, you know, put it on there. I did a bit of white acrylic in, you know, just to get that kind of effect to it. And yeah, so I think altogether the thing probably cost me about £20-25 to make. Can't really go wrong. Anyway, that's enough rambling from me. So you've seen the Doom Box, and hopefully you all enjoy it.